Welcome, welcome all of you to Rockstar Keywords for WLAN Professionals. My name is Rasika Nanajit, your instructor for this digital course. So what we are going to discuss in this course is actually wireless keywords. But before coming to wireless, we will be discussing some keywords in general and talk about wired keywords concept as well. So actually keywords is one of my favorite topic. So I'm glad actually I developed this training for you. When it comes to my learning, actually, I have to be grateful for a few individuals. Actually, a couple of them I've listed here. So Jerome is actually wireless side. I have listened to him many years and learned wireless in general from him a lot. So then another person is Tim Sigerty. Actually, if I focus about wired keywords, actually, there are many talks from him in this particular topic. So I have listed one of the book, actually he and some couple of other authors written, End-to-End QoS Network Design. So if you're focusing about QoS in general and learn about different Cisco products capabilities, I think that's one of the best book so far in this particular topic. So then another RFC I have listed here, both again Jerome and Tim, both contributors of this RFC. Actually, it is talking about how best practices for wireless keywords. You know, like sometimes there are many RFCs are there for wired keywords, some DHCP guidelines, but there are not many guidelines for the wireless keywords. So because of that, in the past, if you have tried to deploy wireless keywords, you may hit certain roadblocks. Some products does not comply. Really, you can't deploy wireless keywords consistently. So in that context, in 2018, this has become a standard. You know, like I think you can read this RFC 8325. We will be going into detail as well. What were the challenges and how this RFC trying to set some guideline when it comes to keywords for wireless. So the other thing, actually, the course flow wise, we will talk about basic concept and then wired keywords, and then we will talk about wireless keywords concept. You know, like this area where I think everybody need to understand wired and wireless is a two different medium. Characteristics are different. So wireless is always half duplex. It's challenging, you know, like when it comes to QoS. So it is always wireless become the weakest link, you know, when you're deploying end-to-end QoS. If you're not deploying wireless QoS well, sometimes your end-to-end experience may be not that great. So when it comes to wireless QoS, we will talk about 9800 more predominantly. That is the sort of controller we use in the Cisco world today, but still ROS is still there. Because of that, we will talk about ROS QoS as well. So then we will wrap up the course with best practices when it comes to wireless keywords deployment. So like any other micro courses or digital courses we develop, I try to keep this hands-on side, you know, like in that way, this involves some sort of hands-on configuration. You know, like I will demonstrate a couple of these configuration in each lessons, and then you will able to put whatever the learning into practice. You know, like we spend time with Wireshark and look at those keywords detail and how you validate those keywords configurations, looking at the packet captures as well. So what we'll do is actually we will begin with the wired side. There are a couple of switches and router in this network, this topology network, and we will connecting to wired phone, and then we will implementing keywords for the wired networking first, and then we'll slowly introducing the wireless side. So we will have a 9800 virtual controller, and then we will have one access point. Initially, we will doing the local mode deployment where the traffic will be tunnel back, and then we will look at the Flex Connect deployment and how QoS can be configured each of this scenario. And then we will look at the same thing with the wire ROS based controller. I have a 2504 in my lab here. Even though it cannot run the latest 8.10, I will talk about 8.10 ROS QoS capabilities in the lessons, but practically when I deploy, it is 8.5, you know, like the QoS in here, what we'll do. So we will be configuring PSK and .1x SSID, and then sometime we will look at how we can use AAA override as well, give a QoS point of view. You can give a client specific QoS. So a little bit about Wi-Fi training. I'm sure you're familiar with our company. So we are basically CWNP and Cisco authorized training partner. But more than that, sometimes we are doing customized training based on the customer's demand. You know, we have developed several digital courses. I'm sure you have get some experience with digital courses as well. So then if you are interested about particular topic, you can pick individual digital courses, or otherwise if your company can go for the all access pass, whatever we are developing courses will be, you will automatically entitled, so you can access to all the digital content we are developing. So we have developed some digital workbooks as well, you know, like specifically focusing about the CWNP training program. That program is a vendor neutral, but if you want to get some hands-on experience specific to those technology path, we have developed workbooks to reinforce your classroom learning with hands-on experiences as well. So a little bit of myself, I'm sure you have familiar with my blog. You know, like I have started this blog in 2012-13, at the time when I do my CWNP and the CCI wireless journey. So that became a good resource for many other around the world. You know, like even myself, sometime I go and refer the blog again and again because I cannot remember everything I learned. So mostly my focus is wireless training, CWNP or Cisco, and addition to that, doing this kind of content development. So I have spent many time in the Cisco support community as well. That is what I do in most of the free time. I'm contributing back or giving back to the community. So without further ado, let's begin.